It haunts you. It haunts you.
Mark Mishu is an Army veteran who served in Iraq. The experience, he says, was gut-wrenching.
You pass by dead bodies on the side of the road. I mean, having to shoot anytime just is bone-chilling. It's an experience that not a lot of people know of, and it's nothing I would ever wish on anybody. I mean, you kind of get the feeling of it's life or death, so it's either you or them. You see craters in the ground, and all you can think of is, what happened here? You know, is this from one of my friends? Is this one of my platoon? Is this anybody in the military? A huge family. So no matter what, you constantly think of, really, I really hope these people are okay.
Mishu was medically discharged in 2010, but what he witnessed remains with him. He finds solace in his hometown of Saugus at Patkin Pond.
Whenever I come here, it's like, it's just a calming, relaxing feeling.
The pond is the meeting spot for Project Healing Waters, a national program aimed at helping veterans cope with stress through the sport of fly fishing.
I can have you fly fishing in 10 minutes.
Joe Cresta, a veteran of the Marine Corps, started a local chapter out of the Malden Anglers Club. Fly fishing, he says, is an escape.
It brings you back to your youth, I think. You know, something peaceful, and there was nothing else to worry about other than where you're going fishing that day after school.
And more than that, unlike trolling or spin casting, fly fishing occupies the mind.
There's more focus involved, I believe. It's more muscle memory, it's more repetitive motion. You can't just throw the worm out there and let the bobber sit, and then your mind wanders somewhere else. This, you have to focus on what you're actually doing.
Mishu's body and mind are engaged. His surroundings are serene. All this, he says, is a healthy distraction.
One of the biggest things is we don't drink. That's one of the biggest things that can lead a veteran into depression if they have PTSD is drinking. I had that issue, and I went into depression, drank a lot, and then met my wife, my family, everything like that. You know, they pulled me out of it. This is definitely a healthy coping mechanism.
Camaraderie is the foundation of Project Healing Waters.
It helps me stay connected with other veterans.
John O'Connor served in the Massachusetts National Guard. For him, Project Healing Waters is all about giving back to fellow veterans.
It's the fellowship. It's getting to work with each other and help each other try to catch fish.
And it's the conversation.
No one here is here to pry, but everyone is very, very helpful, and it's a friendly ear, and it's a judgment-free zone.
Mark Mishu agrees.
I don't even need to fish. Just relaxing. You listen to the lake, you talk to the guys. It's very, very relaxing. Very healthy relaxing.
Though they both say landing a catch is a sweet reward.
When it connects and when you're doing it right, it feels like $1 million.
Wow, a great program. And Joe Cresta says that the fly fishing program is open to all veterans.
Right, just show up is what he says. Show up, he'll take care of the rest, the equipment. He'll teach you how to do it if you've never done it before. They just want you to get there. And they meet once a month in the evenings. It's a convenient time for especially the younger veterans who have busy work schedules but might have free time in the evening. So he tells people, just come on out, just get embraced by our group and you'll like it.
That's wonderful. In the Navy Yard, some saw a dilapidated building, but
they thought it would be a terrific hotel.